Hello friends, welcome to this tutorial. In this video, I will present several smart visualizations I've used in my career that can be useful to describe supply chain processes. These are visuals I've used for network design, re-engineering studies, or data analysis projects. I will focus here on four case studies, where I used smart visualization to present complex studies in a simple way. First, supply chain network design. How can you use linear programming to design your network of factories and warehouses to fulfill market demand? Statistical product segmentation. How can you implement a statistical methodology to segment your products based on the turnover and demand variability? Transportation network analysis with graph theory. How can you use the graph theory to optimize the road transportation network of a retail company? And finally, warehouse picking pathfinding algorithm. How can you implement a pathfinding algorithm based on the traveling salesman problem with a library of Google AI operation research? First example, warehouse picking route optimization. You can find this series of articles in the warehousing operation section of my blog. These were part of the first articles I published 2 years ago. The idea is to improve the picking productivity by reducing the walking distance of operators. The two first articles focused on order batching, which is basically grouping orders in a certain way to reduce the distance between picking locations. And in the last one, we implement a pathfinding solution to find the right sequence of picking location, again, to reduce walking distance. You can find a link to these articles in the description down below. The first visual is a simple warehouse heat map. To give you the context, when you analyze the volumes distribution in your product portfolio, you will usually see a Pareto. That means 20% of your SKU will drive 80% of your volumes. If you transcript this to the picking location, you will find out that the majority of your volume is concentrated in certain zones. This chart can help you to spot them and take actions like distributing high rotation spatially to avoid bottlenecks and waitings in the alleys. How can you build it? Start by mapping the picking locations of your warehouse by linking them with their respective SKU or SKUs, then group them by location to sum the number of lines and calculate the percentage split. Then create an Excel. I'm sorry for the one who thought that it would be with a fancy Python library, but Excel is the most efficient here. Draw the cells and link the values with the table created before. And finally, you can use a simple color coding to spot the zone with the highest percentage. Et voilà, you have your heat map. This animated scatter plot has been used to show the result of a certain pathfinding algorithm. The idea here is to show how the algorithm chooses the sequence of picking location to minimize the total picking distance. First, start by plotting the different picking locations coordinates following the sequence of the pathfinding algorithm and join them with a dotted plot. Then create truncated plots by plotting only p points with p going from 2 to n, and n is the total number of locations in the route. And then you can create a GIF by joining all the frames using the Python library pillow. I will add in the description an article with a detailed tutorial on how to build GIF with matplotlib frames. The next example is a transportation network study using the graph theory. In this article, you can find a case study of using the graph theory as a visual support for a transportation network optimization study involving continuous improvement engineers and operational teams. The idea is to optimize the routing of a road transportation for retailers in Shanghai. We have a distribution center that delivers 54 stores in the area. Stores are located in 4 different provinces, and trucks are delivering several stores per route. The final results looks like this chart. You take all the shipments of 1 year. Each node represents a store. If 2 stores have been delivered in the same route at least 1 time, you create a link. Finally, in one chart, you have a clear visibility of the route planning for a full year, and you can start asking questions. For instance, why these 3 stores in Shanghai are isolated? How can we have all the stores interconnected in the group one and many other? So, how can we build these graphs? Very easy. Start by extracting the shipment records. Group the shipments by route, listing all the stores delivered in the route. And after a small effort of formatting, you can use the Python library Networkx to build these graphs. You can find an article with detailed explanation in the link down below. The next example is supply chain network design and flows. You can find in the blogs two articles related to the design of supply chain networks using linear programming. The idea is to minimize the production costs by choosing the production location while respecting the constraint of supply and demand. The idea is very simple. You have several markets with their own demand of products in pieces, and you have potential locations for your factories. You can choose low and high capacity plants. The main parameters are the fixed and variable cost of production. They depend on the country and the plant capacity. Low capacity have low fixed cost, high capacity have high fixed cost. And the cost is higher if you are in America versus in India. Moreover, you need to consider the transportation cost from the production site to the market. The idea then is to find the right production site to reduce the total cost of production and transportation. So, in the second article of the series, I wanted to show what would be the impact if you consider demand variability. Indeed, to make it short, most of the tools conducted in network design are considering a flat demand, usually the yearly average, to design a single solution. Here, the idea is to show how the solution can vary if you bring some variability in the market demands. The data input are basically a set of Boolean variables for each of the 50 scenarios. For each scenario, I color the square if the Boolean is 1, but that means the site is selected, and let it blank if it's 0, that means there is no site selected. For this, you need to do two things. First, create this Boolean data frame. So for each of the scenario, which Boolean is 1, which Boolean is 0. Then you use matplotlib pcolor functionality. And then you can choose a Cmap for coloring. Here I chose blue. Now we move to the interesting part, the Sankey chart. It is for me the most supply chain type of chart because it's basically representing flows. To come back to the context, each solution is basically a set of decision variables showing where do you need to locate your factories, which type of factories do you choose, high or low capacity, and the production capacity quantity for each pair, factory and market. The illustration is a chart above that is showing that India, which has a competitive production cost, is absorbing most of the demand. How can you build that? First, you need to reformat your data considering two columns, source and target. Then you need to install PySankey, which is a library to build Sankey plot, and then you can build your chart. This is a great way to explain the results of your network design study. For more details, have a look at the link in the description to get ready-to-use source code with dummy data. Final example, product segmentation. The idea is to build a statistical methodology to segment your products based on the turnover and the demand variability. Of course, you can find an article with a detailed explanation on my blog. I put the link in the description. So the context is supply chain operations for a retail company. You have a central warehouse that is delivering several stores for replenishment. You have several thousands of SKU and you need to segment them. First, because you need to optimize your warehouse operation, but also you need to know where you need to focus your attention for inventory management. The first graph is a simple ABC chart based on the turnover. On the x-axis, you have the percentage of the SKUs, and on y-axis, you have the percentage of the turnover. The idea is to measure the percentage of turnover represented by the top 20%, the high runners, and to estimate the percentage of SKU that make 80% of the turnovers. This is exactly trying to spot what is the Pareto of your product portfolio. In one chart, you have the visibility of the rotation of your SKUs that will drive your warehouse layout, your planning and inventory management strategies, focusing on the high runners, but also your product portfolio management, the slope reductions, for instance. You can also bring an additional parameter, the demand variability. Indeed, if your coefficient of variability, the standard deviation divided by the mean, is high, your demand is very unstable. This gives you the visibility on the complexity for inventory management and planning for each SKU. If you have this on the turnover, you have then two good parameters to allocate your resources per SKU. In the green square, you have the very slow movers, so the low percentage of turnover. and you can call them the C items. You'd better allocate limited resources on them. In the red square, you have the high runners that have unstable demand with a coefficient of variability higher than 1. You will focus your effort on these SKUs. And finally, you have the stable high runners in the orange square. They bring revenue without much instability. With this chart, you have enough visibility to build your inventory management strategy, but also design your warehouse layout and processes. You will find the source code with dummy data in the article down below. Finally, with this 5 visual, you cover warehouse operations, transportation routing, supply chain network design, and inventory management. I hope this video gave you enough insights on how to use smart visualization to convey ideas and explain complex calculations. If you have questions, feel free to share them in the comment section.